But in our baptism, our old selves are drowned. That old Adam, that old Eve, that old Cain, that old humanity that still wants to take things in their own hands, that same old person that thinks that everything revolves around them, that the source of all of our brokenness and pain, all of that gets washed away. And it's something that isn't just a once-in-a-lifetime thing. This baptism, this cleansing, this flooding of God's grace goes with us all the days of our life. So in this story, we see this ongoing promise from God that we have a God of grace. That despite how the world may appear, that no matter what might be going on in our lives at the current moment, no matter what we've done or what's been done to us, no matter what, all of that is still redeemed by a God of a flood of grace who bears us up now in a new ark, this Christ that we hear about and know and love and who loves us and forgives us, this Jesus who bears us up above the waters of sin, who carries us to new life. This is the one we remember and we follow during Lent and hopefully onward. This is the one who comes on Good Friday to conquer death in all of its forms, so that we all may truly be a new creation. Have a new life. The life that God has always intended from the very beginning of God's story and ours. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to Jesus. Amen. I know I have words. Hold on. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets.
But in these last days, God has spoken to us by the Son.
So let us say, thank you.
is now time for the giving of our tithes and offerings.
Go